Hello everyone, I'm Rashi Rati and I'm here to explain a very important topic of human resource management, that is training and development. Yes, we might have heard several times about the training and development department in an organization. Now what does that department do? That department is responsible for imparting skills and knowledge to the people. To the employees, yes, that it is responsible for upskilling and reskilling of employees for their job roles. Talking about training, what is training? Training is the act of increasing the knowledge, skills, and competencies of the employee for their current or future job roles. Training plays an important role in this competent and challenging format of business. Training has several objectives. What are the objectives of training? The principal objective of training is to make sure that the availability of a trained, a skilled and willing workforce is there in the organization. And additionally, there are four more objectives, like functional objectives, social objectives, individual and organizational objectives. Individual objectives are helpful to employees in achieving their personal goals, which in turn ultimately enhances the goal of the organization. Organizational objectives assist that organization with its primary objective by bringing individual effectiveness. Functional objectives are maintaining the department's contribution at a level suitable to the organization's needs. Social objectives. Social objectives ensure so the organization is ethically and socially responsible to the needs and challenges of the society. Now further, how to do these training programs? How companies arrange training programs for their employees? There are several methods to that. They can be divided into on-the-job training and off-the-job training as well. On-the-job trainings include job instructions, apprenticeship and coaching, job rotation, committee assignment, internship training, training through step-by-step process. Now talking about off-the-job training, they include classroom lectures, simulation exercises, or business games like case study method, audio-visual method, experiential exercises, vestibule training, computer modeling, behavioral modeling, role-playing, conference or discussions, workshops or seminars. Like, training should be conducted in a systematic order so that employees derive maximum benefits from that. The training system involves four stages. First stage is the assessment of training needs, like what are the training and development needs of the employees actually, and it summarizes all the organizational analysis and the job analysis and the employees' own analysis. First, all the analysis is done and then it is decided what kind of training best suits an employee. Further, stage 2, designing the training and development programs. Like what kind of programs are to be given to the employees. And this considers every learning, teaching and training, all the principles together. And then the designing of the content, like what content to be delivered, like what content of training has to be given. Third stage is the implementation of the training programs. Then before implementing, we have to decide what method of training are we going to give, like on the job training or off the job training. It also includes the characteristics of the instructor who is conducting the program. Fourth step is the evaluation of the training program. It includes all the programs, like when we have implemented the training program, the sudden next step is to just check whether we have established all the standards or not, like what was the program and what were the reactions of the employees. Most importantly, like what learning have they got from there, and what is the job behavior now, as if whether there is any difference in their efficiency or not. Now talking about development is a process that leads to the qualitative as well as the quantitative advancements in the organization, especially at the managerial level. It is less considered with physical skills and it is more considered with knowledge, values, attitudes and beliefs, in addition to specific skills. Employee development programs are designed to meet specific objectives which contribute to both employee as well as organizational effectiveness. There are several steps in the process of management development. They include, first of all, reviewing the organizational objectives, then evaluating the organization's current management resources, then determining individual needs, then designing and implementing the development programs, and lastly, evaluating the effectiveness of these programs and measuring the impact of training on participants' quality of work life. In simple way, it can be denoted as per a formula. The employee development can be stated in a maths formula. We all do addition and subtraction in our daily lives, so we can get a clear understanding through this. Employee development is equal to employee education plus employee skills plus employees the training effectiveness of the employees and plus the employee quality of work life. The sum total of all these factors is in totality the employee development. Hence, development can be said as the continuous process, whereas training has specific areas and specifications. So, coming up to the conclusion, these programs enhance the overall skill set of the employees, thus naturally contributing towards improved organizational structure and creating an employee supportive workforce. So, that was all about training and development. Thank you.